We finally finished assigning the components in the previous video. In this video, we'll discuss a little about the PCB layers and we'll learn how to correlate the physical PCB into the PCB layout editor of KiCad. Let's quickly discuss what PCB is composed of and how we can relate them in KiCad while using the PCB editor. Printed circuit boards are made of various layers stacked up. To keep things simple, let's talk about single layer PCB. First, we have the base. It's a fiberglass material which is solid core that gives the PCB its rigidity and thickness. It mechanically holds the connection and the components just like the perf board or like a breadboard. Then we have the conducting layer. In most cases, this conducting layer is made of copper and connects the electrical connection between the components just like the traditional wires. These connections are called traces and it can be of various width and length depending on what we are planning to connect, which we'll discuss in more detail as we make our own PCB. Also, every time I talk about layers in PCB, like a single layer, double layer or a multi-layer PCB, it generally refers to the amount of conduction layers in the PCB. We can actually stop the production at this stage, just having the base layer and the conduction layer. Let me show you an example. You can see this PCB is almost usable and it does its function. But if you have noticed in day-to-day life, our PCBs are not like this. It's a little different. They come in a green layer on top of this, and that's called solder mask. It protects the PCB surface and insulates the copper circuit from oxidation. It also prevents accidental contact with other materials, solder, or any other conductive bits. It can be of any color, but it's mostly green because it's easy on eyes, and also it's easy to see the difference between different traces, planes, and empty spaces. However, the solder mask doesn't cover up everything on the board. It's applied in such a way that it covers up the small traces, empty spaces, but exposes some space around the component pad so they can be soldered later. Finally, we have the silk layer. This is the layer at topmost with the names, letters, symbols, and usually white in color. It makes the assembly and final working of the PCB way more convenient. And it does not add any physical or electrical feature to the PCB. It is just for appearance. Sorry for going a little off topic over there, but trust me, this will help a lot in understanding while building the PCB on KiCad. Now let's quickly look at the PCB layout editor. For that, you can either click on this schematics.kicad_pcb or you can open your schematics and click on Open PCB in Board Editor. So this will open up the empty PCB layout editor. And it's pretty simple to use. It uses the similar buttons and navigation style from the schematic editor that we learned. Since we already know the basics, we can directly start with the PCB stackup that we discussed a while back. So let's start with setting up the board. Click on this board setup icon. And under this, select board stackup. You can see it automatically selected board editor layers. And here, the prefix F stands for front and the prefix B stands for back. So basically it's the front and back side of the printed circuit board. Based on these prefixes, we have several layers that are used in a PCB. But you can see we have quite a lot of PCB layers than what we discussed previously. So let's try to cut down the things that's not necessary and also discuss few things that we didn't discuss before. First, we have the F.courtyard and B.courtyard. This layer defines a safe area around a component, so while assembling a physical component, they don't overlap each other. And you can see this has been marked with a pink outline. Then we have F-fab and B-fab. Using these two layers, we can give more data to manufacturing without including them in our final design, like mentioning some important points or notes. We won't be using both of these layers, so we can turn it off for now. Then we have F adhesive and B adhesive. This layer would be required only if your component is not easy to mount and require any additional glue or additional material that has to be included. So this layer would indicate where the glue should be applied and where it shouldn't be. In our case, we won't be using that feature as well. So we'll be turning off the B adhesive and F adhesive. Now followed by that, we have F paste and B paste. This two layer would have the information about where we shouldn't apply the solder mask so we can solder the components. Also, these layers are essential in making stencils. So sometimes these layers are also called as stencil layers, which we'll discuss in the future video. Now, from the beginning of the video, you should be familiar with other layers. F-silk layer, F-mask, and FCU stands for conduction layer or copper layer. Similarly, we have the back copper layer, we have the back mask, back silk layer. So since we are familiar with this, we can just move forward and see edge cut. This layer would define the PCB shape and its dimension. And we can use the margin layer to define the area where the components, traces, and any other parts of the PCBs are allowed to be placed or not allowed to be placed. And there are a lot more layers that we won't be using. So we can turn off the user echo. This layer used only if you are sharing the PCB layout file to other engineers, where you can include the revision number of the PCB or any other graphics, drawings, which won't make into the final PCB. We can also turn off the drawing and comments, which are generally used for user reference and nothing much to do with the PCB. Finally, we can also turn off all the user layers. They are user defined layers where we can add special features to the PCB and also to convey some information to the fabrication plant or to some other design engineer. Now just click on OK button. And you can see only the required PCB layers are visible and the non-required ones are ignored. Now we can go back to the board settings and now let's click on physical stack up. If you're just getting started, you don't have to worry most of this. Most of these features are taken care of by the manufacturer. All you have to do is just select the number of layers that we are going to be working on. For now, I'll just select 2. Then next we have the board finish. This gives us various options to have a surface finish for our PCB. I'll make sure to drop a link in the description, which will take you to this article where we have written everything in detail about each type of surface finish. Then we have the solder mask / paste. We can use the information provided in the manufacturer website and fill this information. But most of the cases, you could have pretty good results with just default values. So I'll just leave it as it is for now. Next, we have the text and graphics. These settings are just for appearances and it doesn't affect the PCB in any way. We can change the line thickness, text and other informations. In the next video, we'll add some design rules and bring all the footprint into the PCB layout editor and start with laying out the PCB. Until then, if you have any questions, you can always reach out to us at PCB Cupid. And especially don't forget to like and subscribe and share it with people who might be interested in similar topic. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.